27th of February 2008. We're in London, and what's special about today? Well, we're here at the heart of the country, Westminster, in England. And as you can see, so are a lot of other people today. And that's what makes it so special, because now the people are finding their voice. Gordon, give us a vote. Let the people decide. Where's our referendum? These are the posters and banners here today. And this line is waiting to go into the committee rooms behind us, over the road, where people are lobbying their MPs. They've all come here to tell their MPs why they think we should have a vote on the EU. I'm going to call it a constitution, because calling it a treaty is just rubbish. That's my opinion, and I'm sticking to it. So here we go. All these people here have come to see their MPs. They're taking a final vote, I believe, or near to final vote, sometime next week, on whether they think we should have a voice. This is a democracy. This country is one of the oldest democracies in the world. We gave our system to the other countries that have been growing up around us. And now we end up in a tyrannical society, where other people are telling us exactly what is good for us, what we're going to do, and they're giving our country away to boot. So we're at last finding a voice.
This issue confronting this country, it is a very sad comment on our democracy, such as it used to be, but it isn't no longer, that we haven't got half of London covered in 2, 3, 4, 5 million people, all saying this is the moment more than any before it. And it is the last moment when we'll be able to say we still have what remains of a democracy. If this treaty, if this constitution goes through, that will be the end of the story. We will not be a democracy in any sense, meaningful sense anymore. And that's why I and so many other people are here. I just wish there were a million times more than there are. Okay, good luck to you.
Thank you very much indeed. Thank you. Appreciate that. We've just found John Kelly in the queue here, and he's the press officer for the Southwest region of UKIP. Does a brilliant, brilliant job. You should see the emails. He has us all chuckling, but it's very serious all the same. And we're going to ask him now just what he's doing here, why he's come all the way up from Devon to be here with us today. So over to you, John.
Thank you, Fern. It is a very serious matter, because this is the darkest period of our lives, when the Lisbon Treaty looks like it's going through Parliament. We're objecting here today that it shouldn't go through without a referendum. It's the really serious thing about this treaty, unlike the previous treaties, is that it contains powers which will mean the end of our parliamentary democracy. The treaty contains self-amending powers, which means that the EU will be able to change the treaty and the method by which it governs the member states without requesting an intergovernmental conference, so that people can have a say in the process. Furthermore, decisions of the EU will no longer be by the unanimity rule. They will be by QMV, qualified majority voting, which means that the power brokers in the Commission can push through the legislation they need without unanimity, and the EU Parliament will rubber stamp it. And that completely takes away our long developed parliamentary democratic powers. This place we're at here, I'm outside the Sovereign's entrance at Westminster, is supposed to represent our system of representative democracy, whereby power is with the people and they lend it to the politicians for a maximum of 5 years, at which time the politicians are supposed to return the power to the people. And that is what our sovereignty should be about. And we're looking now for a referendum on the treaty, and if that should fail, we're looking to our sovereign, Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, to advise the government to think again and to hold a referendum on the Lisbon Treaty. I hope we succeed.
You might wonder what we're doing looking at a bag on wheels. Well, We've got people going up and down here giving away a newspaper, and we've just stopped to ask what they're doing and what the newspaper's all about. This is Marilyn, all the way from Bournemouth, and they've come here. These are giving away papers, and she's going to tell us a little bit about them.
We support the UK column, which is edited by Brian Gerrish, and this started off in Plymouth as a very small newspaper, about 5,000 I think, but it's now gone nationwide, and recently we printed 100,000 copies and it's gone all over the country now. So,
and he's doing this all on his own, he's not sponsored by anybody?
He just gets support. It's not, there's no advertisements, it's just support from people from all over.
But nonetheless, we're pressing on. He's doing it and he's doing a fantastic job. And this message is getting out to so many people. And yes?
We must mention the DVD, which he's produced. It's an excellent DVD, and it obviously will be advertised in the paper, and you'll be able to get it online.
And what's that about? Is it about the paper or something else?
It's about a talk he gave on common purpose in Leicester back last year.
I believe I've seen that. Is it not on Google Video also?
Possibly, yes.
Yes, thousands of hits. Right, so, you know, this isn't just sort of a small-time operation. This is really good. We're very serious about it, I believe.
It's growing
massively. This is the public getting to know the inside stories.
Also, this week, we have targeted something like 80 police stations to bring treason charges against this government. Some have been going quite well, but we'll have to wait and see on that. It's the UK column, and you can get this on Google and also on www.ukcolumn.org. And there you will find all about common purpose.
Sounds intriguing, doesn't it? I do recommend you all go in and investigate this. We should all be doing our own research, you know. It's very vitally important that we start really digging in to see what's going on behind the scenes. Well, we were going to the hall to see the speeches, but we've just come across somebody here we've been talking about way back in the queue when we were talking to a lady giving away the UK column. And this is, in fact, the editor of the UK column, the chap that started the whole thing. So we're going to just have a quick word from him and also ask him why he's here today, because it's not just to plug the newspaper. It's something much, very, very important also that he has to do.
Okay. Well, firstly, I'd like to say thank you very much for whoever organised the weather, because it's absolutely wonderful. We've got sunshine and it's fantastic to see so many people here today. This is what we have got to do. We've got to get people in UK woken up so that they understand that the European Union is a dictatorship. And we need to get people lobbying their MPs every day to ask why they have lied about the nature of the European Union, and for people to tell their MPs that they are to take us out of the European Union as soon as possible. It would appear to many people that the evidence is now coming onto the table that our MPs have committed treason. It started with Ted Heath in 1972, and it's been continued through and includes the present government. So my personal charge to Gordon Brown is that at the moment he is committing treason in handing Great Britain away to a foreign power, and he needs to be brought to book and he needs to be tried. And I hope that the people assembled out of Parliament today are going to be demanding that their MPs are brought to book over this disgraceful episode in British history. Thank you very much.
Well, we're still trying to get to the big hall. There's so many interesting things around here, and we're just pausing by Oliver Cromwell's statue I thought you might like to see. As you see, born 1599, the important date is 1658 when he died. Well, very shortly before he died, this is the chap that deposed the crown, the king, the monarchy. He's a parliamentarian, and they took complete charge of the country at that stage, and it was a parliamentary democracy, if you can call it that at that time. But whatever, he
was very unpopular. He didn't run the country well. He was as much of a tyrant as the king had been, and people were extremely happy when he went. The people that were pleased to see him to start with turned on him because he, very similar to today's government, he started dictating to people what they should think, what they should talk about, how they should act. He stopped people enjoying themselves, no dancing, no parties, nothing frivolous, no Christmas. And you can imagine he was very, very unpopular. And people were so pleased to get back King Charles II when he came back. They actually asked to have their king back. And that's when the Parliament and the Crown shared the power. So no one would have absolute power. But of course, today the monarchy has, it's kind of eroded now, and it's still just a constitutional monarchy. And the big question is, how much power does the Queen have now? We've just pulled somebody else out of the queue here. And this is David, and he's the district organiser for UKIP in Bournemouth. And we're going to ask him also what he's doing here today.
Hello, well, I've just heard a passerby as he was going past saying, I don't believe in government by referendum. Well, of course, he's completely missed the point. Whether you believe in referendums or not, the fact remains is that the Labour government that we have in at the moment, in their manifesto, promised the British public a referendum on any constitutional treaty. And of course, they've reneged on that promise. So they're in breach of promise. That is the point, really, of this rally today. And this is why I'm here, to emphasise and to add my objection to that failure to keep their promise.
That's good. Thank you very much. You better get back in the queue before you lose your place. It's a long time. And we're talking now to Elizabeth, and she's the person who organised the coaches to come here, from a coach from North Devon. As you can see from the amount of people here, there's just hundreds and thousands of people here today. It's a fantastic effort by everybody who organised it, so we have to say thank you.
It's brilliant that it's happened, that so many have come up, because everybody has jobs that they have to do midweek, and it's great that so many have come. We didn't have as many as we would have liked from North Devon, but there are plenty from the rest of Devon and from Cornwall. And it's a really good turnout, and thank goodness the sun is shining, which makes it all so much more fun. And then I hope they're going to go and beard their MPs in Parliament and tell them what they think of them if they don't vote for a referendum. We have got to be given a referendum. Brown can't keep hiding behind his stories. It was in his manifesto, and he will go down in history as a man who cannot keep his word if he doesn't give us this referendum. Finito.
Thank you very much, Elizabeth. It's fantastic. And considering it, that this is a working day, it's even more amazing that so many people are here, isn't it?
It is. Yes, you're quite right.
Thank you very much. And we're just going to have a word with Julian, who's standing very patiently in this huge long queue, and see why he's here today. So why are you here?
Well, I would like to demand my referendum, which mainstream parties have for many years made promises on, and they never stuck to one of them. They never stuck to their promise.
Do you feel rather cheated?
Yes. They're naughty boys and girls.
That's good. You're very patient standing here for so long. Are you going to see your MP?
Yeah, possibly.
And you're going to tell him off, I hope?
Yes. So, and if he is in favour of the seventh treaty, which no doubt to do with a mainstream party, he's in favour of an ID interrogation centre. The network is already already spreading without debate.
Great. Thank you very much indeed. You see, there's a lot more to this than we think, isn't there? There's a lot of underlying threats around this issue that we don't all know about. Thank you very much, Julian. And just in case everybody thought that referendums and things were just the sole province of the OAPs, we've got somebody delightfully young here in the queue. He's with a little group of people that are young, and it's Edward. He's 23. And we know that the kids, you know, they're our hope for the future. They're the most important people here today. definitely. So we're going to ask him why he's here today.
Hi, yeah, I'm just here because I think it's awful that MPs are signing away the powers which have been vesting in Parliament for hundreds of years. And I also think that the European Union is a very old-fashioned organisation, believing in giving government more power when what's actually needed is power to be made more local. So I think the European Union is quite old-fashioned and there's no need for it anymore. That's why I'm here.
Thank you very much indeed. And good luck to all the kids.
Thank you.
Well, here we are at the end of the queue. It's a long enough queue, but you have to know that this is 1:30. This is going on until about 4:00 and has been going on from 11 o'clock today. And these people, is a constant file of people going through the hallway lobbying their MPs. And as I said before, this is a midweek day. For people to have be off work and to come here when they could have been working and other things to do is absolutely amazing. It's a wonderful atmosphere here. Lots of cars hooting in agreement with what's going on here. And here we are at good old Big Ben. And the affection that we feel for this clock, it's just amazing, isn't it? And what it symbolises to us. And again, that's why the people are here today. We want our democracy back. That's what they're saying. We're going into the hall in a moment to see if there's some speeches going on. I believe there are. And it'll be nice for people that couldn't get here today to be able to join in this way on the internet. So off we go. We're still trying to get to the hall. We keep finding these wonderful people here and we're trying to take little interviews with them. Let me just hang on. Find my way over to these ladies in a minute and we're going to have a talk to them and see what they doing here today. Well, at last we managed to catch these two wonderful ladies. They've been called for photo shoots and we couldn't get near to them for a little while. But this is really the spirit of what we're here for today, isn't it? And we need more of this. This is what we need through the whole country. So all you people sitting there in internet land, what have you done today to help save your country and bring our democracy back? I'm going to just ask these ladies quickly, what's your name?
Gloria Martin.
And where have you come from and what have you come here?
I come from Putney, where the most marvellous Sir James Goldsmith stood for the referendum party. And I'm like most people, I love Europe, but I do not wish to be governed by Europe. And this is why I'm here today. We've got to win this battle. Otherwise, Britain, England, my country is lost.
Thank you very much. And what's your name?
Jeanette Nathan.
And this is Jeanette Britannia. Britannia, who, as we all know, they're trying to get rid off of our coins now.
It's absolutely disgusting. I mean, she's the model for our country.
Right. Would you like to tell us then why you're doing here today and why you're dressed?
Well, I feel very, very passionate about being British. As Gloria says, one loves Europe, but we can still trade with them. We don't have to be them. And when people realise that half their town hall laws are all made in Brussels, maybe they'll sort of jump up and try and do something, if it's not too late.
That's lovely. Thank you very much indeed.
One last thing, topical, because the post offices are being closed. People don't realise it's because of Europe, because they are saying that Britain is not allowed to subsidise its own post offices. And post offices are a service. That's why we've always subsidised them. I mean, it goes far beyond that anyway. They are heart of the community. And it's just people don't realise. Nobody tells them how their lives are being affected so adversely by this monstrosity called Europe.
Thank you very much. And this is one reason why we're here today doing our interviews. There's a lot of media here. There are big cameras, there are big microphones, professionals. But, you know, they don't tell you the whole story. So out there in internet land, we're getting it, aren't we?
Here's hoping this. They have never, ever, ever shown it. 2 minutes on BBC 24, and that's the only thing that's ever shown it. BBC, ITV are never shown.
Well, this is why we're doing this. We put this out onto Google Video and YouTube, all the internet land, and we've actually got over 150 films out there now with hundreds and thousands of hits, because this is where people go to find out what's really happening. Thank you so much for your time.
I'm assuming if we were to win the bond, then theoretically, talking about tunnel, I'm that's a more global movement.
Well, we're back at the queue again. They're packing up. It's the end of the day. We did make it to the rooms where the speeches were. It was so packed that we couldn't get in. And they eventually had to have two meetings going on at once, with the speakers going from one hall to the other. There were so many people. So it was very difficult to film there. I filmed on a small camera, and you'll see a couple of the films we got. If you just look on Google Video, it'll be alongside this one. Meanwhile, back at the queue here, I've had a very lucky find, and I'm with Tony Bennett. Now, his initial claim to fame is fighting for the British Weights and Measures Society Association, and he's responsible for taking the metric road signs around the country and putting them back to Imperial, for which we thank him so much. Also, he's telling me that he met this morning, front of the queue to get in, was a very famous person. He's going to tell us who it was, and then he's going to tell us what his mission is here today. So over to you, Tony.
Okay. I've been asked to speak to the camera. I arrived here very early, just after 10:30, and we saw Tony Benn, former MP, Labour MP, who is right behind this campaign for a referendum, although most of his party are not. He is supporting a referendum, and we had a very useful chat to him. But I'm here today, Fern, because of this postcard campaign. This is a postcard addressed to Her Majesty the Queen. They're pre-addressed to Her Majesty the Queen. Each has got a unique number on, and this petition card, which hundreds of thousands of people have been signing and sending off, is designed to ask Her Majesty to intervene to refuse the royal assent, her permission, to this bill, the EU Reform Treaty bill, unless we, the British people, first get a referendum. So we believe it's likely that our MPs will not allow us to have the referendum they promised, in which case the only way out is if the Queen will stop this bill and give us a referendum. And basically, Fern, we've had requests for these from hundreds of thousands of people all over the country, and they're still coming in. And today we've been up and down the line here. Almost everybody has signed, and we've actually been up to Buckingham Palace today. I don't know if you know, we've been up to Buckingham Palace and not only handed in these cards, but this letter to the Queen as well. A three-page letter which explains exactly what the campaign is all about, and also reminds her, as it says on the English Parliament website, that she has the right to refuse permission for this bill to go through.
Well, that's just brilliant, isn't it? Wow. You see, today here we've got just about everybody flooding in, and we've got so much pressure going on these people. Something's got to happen, surely. So people like Tony Bennett and a lot of the other people here today, we're the people who are doing something for our country to get our democracy back. Now, say again, I know a lot of you couldn't get here because you're working, because you may be sick, for other reasons, but have you really got that much of an excuse for not joining us today? And just think, at the end of every day, when you're reading the newspapers about the terrible things happening to our country now, think, what have I done about that? There's plenty to do. Let's get one of these postcards, sign it. We're going to put the website up on the over the top of this little film so you can... Got no excuse. Get on the website, audio postcards, and let's get this thing going. Thank you very much,
Tony.
Thank you
very much, Fern. Okay, great to talk to you.